Hello friends, welcome to Insight Learners. So in this video we shall learn the Nano Editor. So with the help of a GitBash terminal, so we shall see how to use the Nano Editor and we shall write a simple Hello World program within the Nano Editor. So before that, do subscribe our channel and like the video. So first we shall open the GitBash terminal and now we shall enter into the Nano Editor. So Nano Editor, it's a editor which is used to write a program. So we can write a program and we shall run it and execute it, and it provides a various options in order to update the contents, undo the contents, and you can cut a line which is not needed, and it provides various options. You can search a line. So if you write if you write a program with 100 lines of program, then it is difficult to debug. So it is difficult to find the bug in the program. So with the help of a search, you can find that line and you can make the corrections. So quickly we shall enter into the Nano Editor. So with the help of a nano, so nano followed by the name of the file which you are going to, so name of the name of a class, that is you are going to create a program and you need to give a name. So therefore nano, first we shall write a simple Hello World program. So nano followed by Hello World program. So nano Hello World program .java. So we shall write nano Hello World 1.java. So we are writing a first program. So we shall write nano Hello World .java, then enter. So you can see this is the Nano Editor. So this is the version of a Nano Editor, and you can see this is the name of the file which we have entered, that is Hello World 1.java. So you can see it is showing that you have entered into a new file. So in order to go out of it, you need to press Ctrl X in order to exit, and then after that you can with the help of a Ctrl W, that is where is, means if you want to search a line or if you want to search a text, you need to use the Ctrl W, and then you can cut a text. So if you do not want that line, so with the help of a Ctrl K, you can cut the text. So you shall see the usage of various options. First we shall write a simple Hello World program. So first we shall write the class, that is public class Hello World 1. So it should be same as that of a name of a file which we have given, that is Hello World. Then so public class Hello World 1. So now we shall write a main method, that is public static void main string of args. So you can see it is showing that it's a justified paragraph. So then you need to write a program in such a way that you give the line space, everything. So then you have written a main method. So void is a return type and you are considering the static, and this is the simple Hello World program. We are writing it in Java. So then we shall directly write this SOP, that is system.out.println. So print statement. So that is system.out.println. So Hello World. So hello. So I'm going to print a message, that is hello everybody. So I'm going to write hello everybody. Hello everybody. Then we shall include one more. Print statement, that is so system.out.println have a good day. So this is how we have written a program, that is we have considered the class, that is Hello World 1. Then this is the main method, that is public static void main string of args. Then we have considered the two print statement, that is Hello World as Hello Everybody as well as Have a Good Day. So make sure that you write a program like this, and then do not make any mistake and see that you are writing it in same fashion. So once this is done, so we shall check with various options. So first thing is, suppose if you want to cut, so suppose now you shall place the cursor here and you want to cut this line. So for cutting the line, you are going to use the Control K option. So this will cut the line. See, you can see it. Initially there were two system dots, two print statements. So with the help of a Control K, we have deleted the text. So in order to undo it, that is in order to make that print statement to commit again, you are going to use the Control U. So this will undo the line. So now suppose if you want to search, so you can also search it, and then if you want to check the current position, you are going to use the Control C. So now we shall see how to search the text. So with the help of a Control W, you are going to search. So here you can search. So suppose if you want to search the static keyword, so just type the word that you want to search, that is static, followed by press enter. So you can see search is wrapped, and you can see the cursor is pointing here. That is, you can easily find the static keyword. And similarly, you can so in order to go out of it, you need to press Control X. So now if you want to check the current position, so Control C. So you can see it is telling that you are, so the line number 3. So you can see this is the first line, second line and third line. So it is telling that out of 8 line, you are saying that there is a you are at the third line. So then this is how you are going to use it. So next you can also, so next in order to sort quickly, we shall exit it, and we shall run a program. So I have typed Control X. So you want to exit it, so it will ask whether you want to save this in the buffer. So it is so buffer, it's a device where you are going to store the program. So it will ask whether you want to save it. So just click Y. So Y with the keyboard. So then it's telling that the name of the file, which is helloworld1.java. So now it will save it. So now if you want to save it in a DOS, so whether you want to save it in DOS, Mac, it will ask. So now so just press enter. So now our file is successfully saved. Now you want to run the program. So first you are going to compile the program, then you are going to run the program. So in order to compile, you are going to use the Java C. So Java C followed by the name of the file, it's hello world 1.java. So first you are going to compile it, so therefore you are going to use a Java C, that is Java compiler. You are going to invoke the compiler to run this to compile this code, that is Java C hello world 1.java, then enter. So if there is no error in the program, so you are going to successfully display it without any error. So now we have compiled the code, and now you are going to run the code. So you are going to run the code just with Java. So you are going to use the Java C in order to compile the code. So now you are going to run the code to display the output. So you are going to use a Java followed by the name of the file, it is hello world 1. So hello world 1. So Java C, so here we did a mistake, that is hello followed by, you have used a small w, so you are going to use a capital W. So therefore Java C hello world 1, so hello world 1.java. So press enter. So you can see we have successfully compiled the code. So now we shall run the code, so with the help of a Java followed by hello world. So Java hello world, so this will display the output. So it is telling that could not find or load main class hello world. It's hello world 1. So therefore you are going to write hello world 1. So now press enter. So you can see it is displaying the output, that is hello everybody as well as have a good day. So this is how you are going to use the nano editor. And you can see you wrote a simple program, that's a hello world 1, and you displayed the messages, that is hello everybody as well as have a good day. So now again, if you want to enter into the nano editor, similarly you are going to write the nano followed by, you are going to enter the name of the file, it is hello world 1.java. So this will again enter into the program. So this is how you are going to write a simple hello world program within the nano editor. And you have also seen how to how to cut the text, and how to undo the text, and you can also paste the text. That is, if you cut the text, then again suppose if you want to undo it or paste the text, you are going to use the Control U. So you are going to use the Control K to cut the line. So here you can see, so it is so you are going to use the Control S in order to save it. So Control S, so it is displaying you wrote 7 lines. See, 3 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So now it's displaying that you have written the 7 lines. So again, if you give the space. So now check Control S again, it will save the code, and then you can see you wrote 8 lines. So at the below, once you save the file, it is also displaying the number of lines you have written. So this is how you can use the Nano Editor to run a program. And again Control X to come out of it. So this is how you are going to use the Nano Editor, and you can write any lines of code within the Nano Editor, and you can invoke a process, or you can use the thread. So you are going to use it with a Git bash. So within the Git bash, you can enter into the Nano Editor and you can write a Hello World 1 program. So we have written the Hello World 1 program. Similarly, you can write many code, and you can write it in any language. So just give the extension. So we have given the .java extension, so we wrote the Java code. So you can write the code, many programs, many Java programs within this Nano Editor. So in the next, so thank you friends for watching. So in the next video, we shall see how to write a program in order to invoke a process, or you can use how to use the thread within the Nano Editor. So thank you friends for watching, and do subscribe our channel for more updates.